Meanwhile, this is International Day of Persons with Disabilities, and tonight there are concerns that rising hospitalization rates could lead to discrimination against people with disabilities when it comes to critical care. Travis Danresh reports.
End the secrecy, make public the recommendations you're considering to govern these life and death decisions.
David Lepofsky is worried. He's also angry. The disability rights activist who is blind is part of a coalition of 64 groups that sent this powerful open letter to the government. It urges Premier Ford to ensure patients with disabilities don't face discrimination in accessing care if COVID surge overwhelms hospitals and doctors, equipment and beds have to be rationed.
If that horrible situation were to happen, we need to know who's going to decide and how they're going to decide who will get refused the life-saving critical care that they medically need.
In March, the government's initial triage plan was leaked and faced criticism from medical experts and others saying it discriminated against people with disabilities. The plan was ultimately rescinded, but new protocols have not been shared publicly. We asked the minister if that would happen this time round. Christine Elliott gave a long response.
This is a very important issue.
But did not answer the question.
That will come forward at the appropriate time.
It's a genuine, valid, real concern.
The opposition is also pushing for transparency, saying the government has an obligation to reveal the protocols and how they were determined.
Well, the government should be making that, clear and open to people so they know as well, too, you know, what the questions that are going to be asked in that kind of a situation.
Those questions back in March included something called the clinical frailty scale, which is used by doctors to determine the level of fitness or frailty in a patient. It's unclear if that same scale is being used to make decisions moving forward.
This is basically like a list of who has disabilities. If you have a progressive disease and you rate really badly on those 11, you are more likely to be refused critical care if we need to ration.
Lepofsky says, at its core, that is discrimination. It's why he and thousands of others want answers now on who the government plans to prioritize if life and death decisions need to be made. Travis Danresh, Global News.